Our story begins in 1861, the year Abraham Lincoln was elected president. The Civil War had just begun. The West was still wild, and the car had yet to be invented. On the St. Clair River in Michigan, a boy was born to James and Harriet Smith. They named him Christopher Columbus Smith. He would become a man who defined boating pleasure, not merely for generations of Americans, but across the globe. Living in modest circumstances, the Smiths were hard-working people who embodied the pioneering spirit that built America. The values that shaped Chris Smith live on in the boats that leave the Chris Craft Boatyard today. Chris opened his own manufacturing facility in Algonac on the St. Clair around 1884. Working with his brother, Hank, Chris spent the next 25 years hand-building a succession of duck boats, canoes, rowboats, sailboats, and ultimately, steam-powered launches for affluent businessmen. With every new boat, Chris's reputation grew. At the turn of the 20th century, the internal combustion engine arrived. At almost exactly the same time that Henry Ford was contemplating how to put a gasoline-powered motor in a mass-produced car, Chris Smith was thinking about how to incorporate one in a boat. Using an early 2-horsepower Stintz engine, Smith can rightly be described as a founding father of powered boats. Chris Smith's first speedboat could travel at the unheard-of speed of 7 miles per hour. Realizing the potential of gasoline-powered boats, Chris Smith set out to improve his early designs. He realized that the way water flowed over a hull at speed required a different, more dynamic shape than traditional boat designs. Smith's quest for efficiency led him to design a succession of innovative boats. Bitten by the speed bug, Chris Smith began to develop competitive speedboats for racing. American powerboat racing became a popular sport, and the rivalry between competitors precipitated a wave of innovative new designs. Between 1914 and 1921, with Gar Wood on board, Smith's boats won the American Powerboat Association Gold Cup 6 years running. His boats set new speed records that only his own new designs could beat. Between the two world wars, pleasure and comfort became as important as performance. Although Chris Smith's hull designs were still the best, the challenge the company now faced was keeping up with demand. Chris Smith's company was the first boat building business to standardize its design. In doing so, it was able to achieve a universal standard of quality, for which the company became renowned. In 1924, a new nickname was used to describe the company's boats. They were called Chris Crafts. Chris Craft proudly described itself as the world's largest builder of all mahogany motorboats, producing almost 1,000 boats a year. Quality standards were so rigorous that timber yards referred to their highest grades of wood as Chris Craft quality. By this time, Chris's son Jay had become president and general manager, a post he would hold until 1958, when leadership of the company passed from Chris's son to his grandson, Parson Smith. Chris Smith never knew the horrors of World War II. He died in 1939. But the company he created was well-equipped to help America liberate its European allies. Always adapting, always innovating, Chris Kraft built more than 10,000 landing craft. On June 6, 1944, a Chris Kraft LCPL became one of the first Allied vessels to bring troops ashore on the Normandy beachhead. By 1960, the company's headquarters had moved from Algonac, Michigan to Pompano Beach, Florida. Chris Kraft had never been stronger or more popular among its customers. With the advent of fiberglass, traditional skills gave way to new technology. However, Chris Kraft's new fiberglass boats continued to be built with the same degree of craftsmanship as its old mahogany runabouts. Chris Kraft built its last wooden boat in 1972, but wood is still a major feature in every boat that leaves the yard today. Over the years, many American families have owned Chris Krafts. Among them, the Vanderbilts, the Sloans, the Morgans, and the Fords. There is no greater accolade than the fact that two American presidents bought Chris Krafts and used them to relax with their families. The first movie star to buy a Chris Kraft was Helen Morgan in 1928. Since then, Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, Katharine Hepburn, and even Elvis Presley have all been customers. Today, Chris Kraft boats are still bought by stars, but they're also stars in their own right. They've been seen in countless films and written about in novels.
So, how fast did this old tub go anyway?
The story of Chris Kraft is the story of the American dream. It's a cultural icon that gave Americans a new freedom to explore rivers and lakes, great bays, and distant shores. Our journey through Chris Kraft's distinguished history brings us to the company's latest collection of boats. Before you even step aboard, graceful lines describe an elegant and graphic shape that is best described as sheer beauty. The values that defined Chris Kraft in 1874 define the company today. Historians tend to agree that Chris Kraft, more than any other boat company, is responsible for America's romance with boating. This is an association that Chris Kraft has no intention of ever changing.